I want to show you some of the tools that I find useful in making boxes. Now, the first and probably most important to me is a table saw. And the table saw is a thing that it does so many different things. It cuts wood to size and shape, and it allows you to get a great deal of precision. And so this saw is an antique, actually. It's an Atlas from 1948. This is a newer model planer, and you really want a planer that planes to the right width for you, handles the size of material that you want. Small planers like this actually do a better job for box making than one of the great big ones that you'd find in a cabinet shop. So that's a lucky thing. You don't have to spend thousands of dollars to get really good results. And this is a jointer, and the jointer and the planer actually work together as a 1-2 punch. The jointer provides one flat side, and then you go to the planer to finish your cut. And so if a board goes into a planer and is warped, it's going to come out warped on the other side. So the jointer is a very effective tool at making your wood ready to plane to a perfect surface. This is a belt and disc sander, and it's very useful for me in making small boxes. It's particularly good at doing the rough sanding before you get to the finer finishes. And you'll notice that I have the angle set at what may be rather unconventional to most people, but this really allows me to hold a box and check it regularly. This is the tool that I've had the longest as a woodworker. My father bought it for me when I was 14 years old, and it was a birthday gift. And it's a 1948 shop smith that he bought used. And it's been a real workhorse. I use it as a drill press and as a lathe. And right now, it's outfitted with a accessory table that gives a real accurate fence and a real steady platform for drilling and making parts. And this is a small 14-inch bandsaw. And I use it for resawing to make thick stock thin to make the boxes. The last two tools that I consider real important in my box making are this pad sander. You can see it, you might recognize it in this position, but like this, with this, you can use regular sandbags around it, but I have an old inner tube that I filled with sand, and it just holds it steady so that instead of having to hold the sander and get all worn out, I hold the box, which is usually a lot lighter than this heavy-duty sander. The other thing I want to introduce you to is my simple router table. Now, you've seen all kinds of router tables. You may have one that's really fancy, but mine is not. This is just a simple piece of plywood. You can see that there's a router mounted on the underside. And the fence is a simple pivoting affair. I just unclamp it, and I can adjust this however I want. I can clamp stop blocks on the router to make it very accurate in cutting things. And I can make different size plates here that serve different purposes and give a little better security on cutting small objects.